السلام عليكم ميدل تو. ان شاء الله النهارده عشان الكونكشن ما كانش كويس، اول الناس اللي ما حضرتش هنبدا ان شاء الله our presentation about unit 1. تمام. About attempts of elements classification. تمام. Let's start this video about attempts of elements. You see my screen. Wait for share screen. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
By the end of
okay, بس share screen. You show now my screen. Let's start this video.
Let's summarize everything we have learned about the attempts of elements classification. Due to the increase in the number of elements, scientists strive to arrange and classify these elements into different groups according to the similarities between their properties. Mendeleev was the first scientist to create a real periodic table. He arranged the similar elements based on their chemical and physical properties in vertical columns ascendingly, according to the increase of their atomic weights. Therefore, he left gaps for the discovery of new elements, and he fixed the wrong atomic weights of some elements. However, Mendeleev's periodic table had some disadvantages, because the scientists dealt with the isotopes of the same element as different elements due to the difference in their atomic weights. And he also had to disturb the ascending order in the atomic weights of some elements in order to put them in groups that suit their properties. In 1913, the British scientist Moseley discovered that the periodicity of elements' properties is related to their atomic numbers, not to their atomic weights. As the atomic number of each element increases by one from the preceding period, so he arranged them accordingly. He also added the inert gases in group 0 and classified each main group into two subgroups according to the difference between their properties. And he specified the planes below his table for the two series, lanthanides and actinides. After that, scientists reclassified the elements in the modern periodic table, and it consists of 18 vertical columns called groups and 7 horizontal rows called periods. The elements in this table are classified into 4 blocks, S, P, D, and F. These elements are arranged according to their atomic numbers and the way of filling the energy sublevels with electrons. Now, we have finished summarizing the main points of this lesson.
Okay. Let's convert the second slide about modern periodic table. Okay. إن شاء الله
There are 118 elements in the modern periodic table. 92 of them are abundant in the Earth's crust, while the rest are prepared artificially. In this table, there are 18 vertical columns called groups and 7 horizontal rows called periods. Elements of the modern periodic table are classified into 4 blocks, S, P, D, and F.
Okay, wait. Sorry for disturbance. The second video, inshallah, about modern periodic table. waiting for the video played, inshallah. Attention in this video. إن شاء الله يشتغل دلوقتي. بسم الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Attention.
There are 118 elements in the modern periodic table. 92 of them are abundant in the Earth's crust, while the rest are prepared artificially. In this table, there are 18 vertical columns called groups and 7 horizontal rows called periods. Elements of the modern periodic table are classified into 4 blocks. S, P, D, and F. Click on each block to learn about it.
تحبوا أعمل كليك على إيه الأول؟ يلا S block.
The left side of the periodic table is called the S block elements. These are arranged in two groups, 1A and 2A.
Okay, next P block.
The right side of the periodic table is called P block elements. They are arranged in 6 groups, from group 3A to group 7A, and the zero group, which contains the inert gases.
Okay, let's D block.
The middle part of the periodic table is called the D block elements, which are known as transition elements. These elements are arranged in 8 groups, starting from the fourth period, and they are all characterized with the letter B, except for group 8, which includes 3 columns.
The last block, F block.
Below the periodic table, F block elements are located, containing 2 series, lanthanides and actinides.
Okay, let's convert into the third slide exercises about graduation of elements. Bismillah. المفروض ان انتوا دلوقتي معايا. The D block contains what elements? D block كانت في الميدل طبعا. How many elements? Not how many. What's the name of these elements? D block contains transition. Excellent. Noor, ولا أحمد, ولا Noor, ولا محمد. Show answer, transition elements. Next, the new number of zero groups is what? And it contains what elements of what? The new elements of zero group is what? New number of zero. يعني in modern periodic table, في naming الجديد. في المودرن نيمينج الزيرو جروب كانت بيفور بعد كده بقى اسمها ايه 18 جروب 18 And it contains how many elements? How many elements? 6 elements. Starting with helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Of what? Of inert gases. Inert gases is means noble gases. Okay, let's next. Mosley discovered after studying what? That the periodically of the properties of elements are related to what and what. طبعا Mosley scientist related to what and what. It's a table. Related to atomic number, not mass number. Okay, طب discovered what after studying what? Studying what? X-ray. Okay. Next, what is the number of protons inside the nucleus of the atom? Number of protons inside the nucleus, atomic number. Elements of the same period are different in their chemical properties. Elements of the same period, different in chemical properties. Same period, right or wrong? Right. Bohr discovered the protons inside the nucleus. Bohr is discovered the protons. Who discovered the proton? Not Bohr, taban. He is Rutherford. This is wrong. Next. Which is the following belongs to the same group in the periodic table? Same group. The difference between them, 1 or 2, from 1 to 8, yani. We find sodium and lithium. Okay. Mosley's periodic table, add what? Add 0 group or lift the gaps from the newly discovered elements or corrected the wrong atomic weight or added lanthanides and actinides. طبعا added lanthanides and actinides. طبعا هو مش هو اللي عمل adding ل 0 group. تمام؟ Let's make a new slide, tests of attempts, okay? Let's start. The D block contains what, how many elements? This is the same questions. Oh, the same questions, okay? Okay, we have here we have final examination. Okay, this is final examination. We will take the questions of unit 1. Elements in group 1A are called the alkali metals. As their elements reacts with what? Alkali metals, forming what solution? First, we must make a simple revision about this unit, okay. طبعا دي revision في الأول. There are attempts to classify elements, and then Mendeleev, Mosley, and the modern periodic table. They are 4 blocks, which we watched in the video, and then. In this lesson, graduated talk about graduation of properties of elements, atomic size, electronegativity, metallic and non-metallic properties, atomic size, طبعاً, in the period and in group, atomic size decrease from left to side to right, and from up to down in the group increase, okay, as this picture. Electronegativity is the ability of the atom bonded by a covalent bond to attract the shared electrons toward it. Graduation, the opposite of atomic size. Atomic size through period decrease and through group increase. This is the opposite. Electronegativity increase in the period from left to right and through the group decrease from up to down. This is electronegativity. And they are polar compounds like water and ammonia. Ammonia, the formula in H3, water H2O. Give reason, water and ammonia are polar compounds. They are different in electronegativity. Relatively high. لازم نقول كلمة relatively high. This is summary for all properties. Metallic and non-metallic and metalloids and noble gases. Metallic outermost energy level less than 4 electrons. Okay. Lose electrons and form positive ions. Number of positive ion equal number of lost electrons. You know metals. This is transition elements. Graduation of metallic and non-metallic. This is very important. Any period starts with a strong metal in group one. And the metallic property graduated decrease by increasing the atomic number. Followed by metalloids, and the non-metallic property appears by increasing the atomic number, the strongest non-metal. Then, طبعاً ده في group 7A, اللي هو 17, and the end inert gases. This is metallic property through the group. Metallic characters increase as we go downwards within a group. This is a very active metal, cesium or lithium, cesium. Give reason, because metallic property increase as we go from up to down. Metal react with dial HCl. Oxygen and water. But copper, no reaction with dial HCl. Okay. And then reaction with oxygen when we burn the magnesium. طبعا احنا عملنا الاكتيفيتي ده في اللاب خلاص. Give me magnesium oxide. It is a white powder. When we add water, give me magnesium hydroxide. It is a basic compound because it is base turns litmus solution into blue, litmus paper into blue. Okay. Reaction with water. They react potassium and sodium immediately when it put it in water. Calcium and magnesium react very slowly with cold water. Zinc and iron react with water vapor at a high temperature. Copper and silver don't react with water. Non-metals, the opposite of metal. Outermost energy level has more than 4 electrons. Okay. Semi-metals or metalloids, they are boron, silicon, arsenic, tellurium. You should know the name of each element. كده الوقت بتاعنا متهيألي خلص. إن شاء الله هنحاول بإذن الله المرة الجاية يبقى فيه إيه. هنكمل يعني الريفيجن بتاعنا بإذن الله. النهاردة رجعنا على يونت 1 وشوفنا فيديوز معينة تمام about attempts and graduation of properties تمام. See you إن شاء الله المرة الجاية بإذن الله. Next time I miss you so much. Middle 2, try to study hard and thank you middle 2, goodbye.